Yes, sir, the churning of the Milky Ocean has produced a lot of opulential entities. Whenever the circumstances of the world is churned by means of crisis, by means of impending and permeating dangers, their most great personalities emerge. Just as the churning, it produced opulential entities like Nectar, Airavata, Uchashravas, etc. Whenever there is a crisis, in the name of overruling of power, colonization, imperialism, racial discrimination, linguistic barriers, whatever may be the source for bifurcation, trifurcation, or the divisional ruling of the state, it creates such a crisis which results in the emergence of great personalities. Just as it has been quoted by Burke, it is the problem of the society which gives birth to great patriots. Patriots are born only in crisis. So we have taken two topics as an integral study. One is a crisis and second is about a personality. And the crisis happened at 1857, even though there was a never-ending spirit of fighting against the aliens in the society, which started when the Trade Council of the East India Council that penetrated inside our waters. From that it was started and the bitterness was showered, but still it took a final shape, a gigantic shape, an effective personification of the bitterness and opposition of the society has been shown only in 1857. So it is a hallmark. So that is a crisis, and that crisis has produced like Nana Sahib, Rani Lakshmi Bai, these are all the personalities, like Tantia Tope, lot of personalities, they have emerged out of this crisis. So we are now, according to the analytical studies, history consists of two types. One is the mere theoretical history, second is the applied and analytical history. Just reciting the incidents, just memorizing these things for examinations, just to understand about the life of people, their death, their ruling and other things, it has no purpose. History must be read and it must be revised with an analytical approach, what it contributes to the modern world, contemporary world, and how the messages can be taken to the modern generation. What are the differences, what are the similarities, how it can be taken to the other generations. That is the pursuit of the modern historical studies, which is known as analytical history or applied historical pursuit. On the basis of this thing, what we have to get from the crisis and crisis scrutiny, also from the personality, what we have to get for national security, national integrity and development, and social amicability, socio-economical development, political stability and other factors, that is a different subject to be decided in a different seminar itself. What history has taught us with 1857 and Jhansi Bhai on these various issues, socio-political, economical, natural, global, all of these international relations, everything must be analyzed in a different perspective. To begin with, let me start with the basic biological instinct of everybody, that is known as liberty. Even if you put an ant inside a bottle, you must be saying that it will be tottering and crawling inside. So each one has its own basic instinct of liberty or freedom, by which it wants to move in its own course of function. Whatever it is decided to do, whether that is salubrious or futile, it may be pernicious or endangering, irrespective of the fructifiable status of its functional consequences, each and every species of the creation of God, it continues to exist in its own way of thinking and execution. So, especially this freedom and liberty, according to Shastras, because Shastras, they deal with Paratantriya, that is dependence. So dependence and independence, the Shastras give a different type of meaning. One is absolute independence, independent dependence, dependent independence. These are the various ways. Four major divisions. Even though if a person may be independent, for example, we are always independent in a free society, but we are dependent on the rules of the land, the constitution and other frameworks. It is known as dependent independence. Just as a child is tied to a cot, in order to have a free movement within a limited radius, without being exposed to danger creating substances like glasses or sharp objects or fire or something else, the mother used to tie. That is known as dependent independence. God has given us limited independence, but for that independence he has made us to be dependent on him. According to Shastras, real independence is impossible. We are dependent on various things for our survival, development, other things. Shall I define independence as per the Vedas? Real and secure independence is to be dependent, real independent, who is God. Sarvatantrasya, sarvatantra swatantrasya, purushasya, paramatmanaha, sharanaravinde, paratantriyanushthanam, tatru swatantriyam. Real independence is to be dependent on a really independent as well as a caring and merciful personality. Absolute independence, you have seen a lot of absolute independence of the rulers, which has resulted in imperialism and tyranny. Absolute independence within the citizens that has created a careless, a structureless, a frame, networkless society, wherein when the people are nomadic in style, the people are prevaricated and perfunctory in their duties, the people are demoralized and aberrant in their spiritual, ethical and moral values. So, dependence and independence, you must ask two questions. What is independence and dependence? If you want liberation, what is that liberation? What are the things that you are to perform? What are the things that have been specified by the scriptures or by your conscience or by the society? To execute those things, you must not have any barriers. For executing them things, you must not have any control. For executing those things, you must not have any sort of demarcation. That is known as independence. So independence is a specific nomenclature. Independence is a specific liberty given for you to be free to perform anything that caters to the development of you and the society. It does not give anything absolutely. You can do anything at any time for anybody. So as you are in a global network and a national phenomena, anything that is within the framework of the all-round collective phenomenal salubrity and development for the society must be pondered by a person. So dependence, if you are dependent on poverty, then the dependence is to be totally nullified. If you are dependent on national development, dependent on the security agents, dependent on the political agents, dependent on the intellectual authorities, so these dependents are known as benevolent dependence. It is known as benevolent dependence. And that type of independence in which the persons are binded with such a freedom, which is very dangerous, which in Shastras we used to say a rejoiceable dependence and insecure independence. Apayakara Swatantriya and Surakshita Swatantriya. So we have to classify what is independence and dependence. Then we can compare 1857 with the 2008. Then we can see exactly the same situation is prevailing now. We can explain it. Somebody asked what is the difference between that post-independence and pre-independence India. I told that all the worldly denizens are our brothers. Before 1947 we have been troubled by our cousin brothers. Now we are troubled by our own brothers. We are troubled at all. If you put a classification between a colonial rule and also the modern pseudo-democratic rule, we have the same thing. That necessarily must produce entities like Jhansi Rani Lakshmi Bai. And that is the goal of this conference, which the message has to spread to the teachers, those who can create Jhansi Rani Lakshmi Bai. Those people have been created by three people. Jhansi Rani was having such a great family background, like Drona and Ashwathama, they belong to Kshatra Brahmana Parampara. Drona and Ashwathama, in spite of being Brahmins, Vinashaya Chadushkritam, Parashurama, he has taken that. But unfortunately, they have to serve with loyalty to Duryodhana, that is entirely different. But the bravery, misplaced bravery, that was there with them. It was properly placed bravery. It is known as a potential Brahminhood. Sharma is a civil power and Varman is known as that administrative power or military power. That's why the people are affixed with those things in their family names, traditional names. Likewise, the Sharma Shakti of the family tradition.